I could listen to this song all day. A rising star. And I always say, me look all together, sing baby. We watched him grow from a young boy into a man, a husband, a father. And today's here to share with us his interpretation of beauty expressed through, of course, this beautiful song. Ramin!
How are you doing? Good morning.
Always so happy to see you, man.
Thanks for having me.
How have you been?
Great. You know, it's beautiful. And I'm just here. You know, just advancing.
One of the things I've loved is the way this pandemic has allowed us to see a little bit more of you through your social media.
Yeah, yeah, YouTube channel.
Yes, yeah, yes.
Rugged Nation is large.
Yes, man, the engagement with your wife, your kids. Mm-hmm. So natural. So, and so this song, why did you feel inspired to do this song? Because when we see you on social media, we know you love her.
Yeah.
We know you absolutely adore her. Why put it into words?
I mean, I've done this before in quite a few songs. In This Together was, you know, a song that I wrote for her as well. Mm-hmm. I put that song behind our proposal video.
Yes.
You know, and it was beautiful. People loved it. But this song was, I wrote this song probably about 2 years ago.
Okay.
And it was just out a singer, you know, getting up, whether it's in the mornings or in the afternoons, wherever we're going. She would spend a little bit more time in the mirror putting on the makeup and thing, you know, which I have nothing against, you know, but I always feel like it takes too much time.
Yes.
You know? So why you always do that? You know, in or out the makeup, you are beautiful to me, you know, and I wrote the song and just have it somewhere in some corner. I think I'll cobweb did I grew up on it. And, you know, since we started the YouTube channel, In one episode, I decided that I wanted to introduce the song, just to play the song on my keyboard at home. And the moment I did that, everybody seemed to love the song. They were saying, record it, put it out.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like out of fun and just wanting to, you know, just include and have the Virgo Nation family involved more in what we're doing. And the song just turned out to be one of the most beautiful songs. People loved it from then. And, you know, we spend a lot of time on the production, myself and Nico and Riff and all the musicians that worked on it. And it turned out to be one of the most beautiful songs now. It's like my favorite song of a sudden.
And I'm thinking, did you even imagine that the song would reflect just the thoughts of so many people and so many women?
Yeah, I was looking at it as a simple song. Mm-hmm. But then you realize that, you know, sometimes simplicity and just and just saying something the way
truth.
you want, yeah, the truth, basically, that's it. Just saying it from the heart and exactly how you would say it and not trying to be too perfect with your words. And I feel like that was the effect that it had on people now. And it's just amazing to see and to hear, you know, people, just your reaction from the song, then the music video.
Mm-hmm.
It's just amazing and I'm grateful. I know Liz is grateful, but on a wider scale, you know, she have said it, you know, she want every woman around the world to feel this way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and she's now saying it's their song, it's our song to the ladies, and that is amazing.
Lord, I know some women must cry when they hear it. Did she cry? Or because she knew it before, she never bothered?
I feel like because she knew it before, you know, but she's somebody that she mark hard to when it comes down to me and writing music.
Mm-hmm.
She's one of the first persons that would hear a song that I write at home or wherever. I'll come home with a demo and sometimes she'll be like, nah. You know, so, you know, when you can write a song for her or, you know, any song and she give you a pass, it is a big plus.
Yeah.
You know, so it's just amazing to see her reaction nowadays and just wanting the song, not wanting it to feel like it's just for her, but she's saying, ladies out there, it's our song.
Yeah.
Virgo Nation is our song. It's a beautiful thing to see.
Yeah, it's amazing because, I mean, if you hear men talk, really, and that's why I say it captures truth. It's something that men will say all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah, it takes so long. You don't need to put on that.
True.
You look all right, man, but at the core of it, I always say to them, you know, she's doing it for you, though.
True.
And so part of it is, I think, bringing women to this level of confidence that you are beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? And like you say, you probably never thought about it, but is that the feedback you've been getting from women, that this has made them more confident in how they look? And are the men saying, thank you, Rami, and yeah. call a long time, me, I tell her, I say, she's all right.
Yeah, in DMs,
yeah.
you know, and, you know, just stories and Instagram or wherever, you know, like literally, women are saying, thank you. Mm-hmm. You know, like, no, I can, you know, get up and post a video and not having to feel like, you know, I need to do too much.
Yeah.
You know, and that is the level that I would want to, like, on a wider scale, I'm all about, you know, unconditional love, you know, and seeing beauty no matter what. Whether you wake up this morning, you just wake up, or you're just going to bed, you know, you're beautiful. And that is what we want all women around the world to know today, that you are beautiful. You don't have to do everything, and, you know, I don't have a problem with it, you know, but you should know that without it,
you're beautiful.
You know, you're beautiful.
Yeah.
And that is how we want every woman around the world to feel.
Yes, so. All of the man them. So the man them right now, I said, Romy, and look here, seriously.
No, man.
You put me in a problem.
A while ago, so I would say to me.
Tingle is good. But tell me what.
Him say.
Clive.
Yeah, Clive say, yeah, my woman love it and thank you for that one. You know, so it's a great thing, you know, and, you know, my hope is that this song will be like somebody wedding song.
Yes.
You know, like, just play it whenever, wherever. It's a song for...
It's timeless.
Whichever
it's timeless. And I find music that reaches the soul and the spirit is timeless. And it's one of
most
these
definitely.
Songs that's... I mean, once you hear it, you say, no, man, we're Romanian, dig up that song. Yeah, it's nice. So you have some men across here, they're Romanian. You say, and the man, they're Romanian.
No,
why you going to say that? No, and put me in.
No, I'm not anybody across here.
They're not across here.
Yeah.
The one behind the camera right there, so might be a problem before you go. Walk, so when you come, be careful. So, you know, it's just the power of music.
Mm-hmm.
And has that been your experience? This is one of the songs that you've done. But you have, every time they bring up issues of... sexual abuse of children, I always say, me a quote, Rami and dirty man.
Yeah, man. Yes,
so
man.
You find that's the power that you have.
Yeah, I believe so. And the next thing, I know I mentioned it earlier, but I feel like whenever, you know, we're writing and whenever we're creating, whatever you're doing, whether it's music or whatever in life, just create it from a pure place. Don't try to imitate anything out there that you see. I mean, we have to learn from each other and use, you know, other ideas, but just make it come from a pure part. Because when we're creating Dirty Man, we were wondering, should we say dirty? Because maybe, you know, and we're so concerned about using the word dirty in a song. But that was what I was feeling at the time, because
yes, man.
This was how I was genuinely
and
feeling inside.
That's who
that is. That's who you are, you know, and... You know, I'm glad the moment we decided not to change the word from Dirty Man. And it is, you can see nowadays in society, like every day, even yesterday on the news again, it was something with this 50-year-old man and the 8-year-old.
Yeah,
it really and truly is such a big concern for me. And every time I see it, it's like it's a pain in the heart to see how we're treating children and women nowadays. And That's why I just create from the heart and try to be as real as possible with the
always,
message.
Always, Romain. Yeah. I mean, that's one of the things I admire so much about you.
Thank you.
I always go back. I mean, you walked in here. Did you even imagine? I mean, when you walked in here, the Altogether Sing judges said, this boy is a star.
Yeah, I remember.
Yeah, them said, him is a star. Did you at that age even envision this for yourself?
Well, I always see myself, you know, being an artist and singing, but I would say the way of how things happen, you know, it's kind of surprising to me. I remember I just said Dennis Rushton and all the other judges from Altogether Sing Days, you know, and then come Rising Stars. You know, it just shows that if you put your mind to what you do, if you love what you do, if you work hard at what you do, you know, and just stay focused at it, then you can reach, you know, anywhere in life.
Listen, Romain, you deserve every accolade. You deserve absolutely every fan that you have across the globe because you come from a pure space, always representing people. Legacy, you know, legacy. Virgo legacy.
Thank you.
Yeah, really, really happy to have you this morning. And gentlemen, learn the words of this song. Play it in the background.
Yeah.
You're not going to maybe sound on the same key as Romaine. But listen to him, make him guide you. Your ladies will love you for it. It's beautiful. Thank you, Romaine.
Thank you so much, David.
Thank you for this.
Pleasure.
Same fan them here, Timbo. Ask him for sing. Ask him for sing. Listen to the song. Romaine Virgo, international recording artist.
So we got it, huh?
You want the truth or you want us to be friends?
Truth.
You want the truth?
Yeah.
No. Sheffield would say cut. Coming up, we're going to discuss dengue awareness in our 10 minutes to your health. I feel like it's a good 2 hours, Keith. I feel like it's a good 2 hours. Sheffield, what are you doing? That's what you're supposed to say.
No, you're not used to romance. You're not used to romantic movements.
Like,
in the
I understand why I have Romaine right here with the vibe. Mister, when you're not dead, they play the music. I'm not saying you're going to.